Jingles we fly by. Hello, my tinglings. Today I'm going to do a video on map projections, which I'm super excited about. I thought about doing this video, well, I came up with the idea yesterday, and I was amazed that it took me this long to think of doing a video on this. I have two maps right now in my house. You've probably seen my Australia map. I don't know why I'm pointing backwards because it's not there. But obviously I've done a couple videos using my Australia map. I also have a US map that shows it with Alaska and Hawaii, but with the Atlantic Ocean in between. So sometime I'll do a video using that map. But I know the question you're all dying to know the answer to is, why don't I have a world map? And we will get into that as we discuss map projections. So, with any map, because it's representing a globe, so we have obviously something very spherical, there are distortions that are inherent in making a globe flat. So, there are different aspects that will be distorted, and certain map projections will aim to kind of to minimize or eliminate the distortion of usually one of these areas. So you have a physical area. So if you want everything to look roughly similar sizes to each other, you can get maps that are equal area maps, and we'll look at a couple of those projections. You can get equal, correct shape. So if you were looking at the globe and the item or area that you were looking at is basically front on right here, then that's kind of its shape, so the correct shape, but if it was looking off to the side, it would be a bit distorted. And so certain maps favor making sure that the outlines of all of the countries and land masses are correct, but then you may get differences in size that will really skew the sizes. You also have equal, another distortion can be direction. So using for navigation, obviously you kind of want it to be, if you're traveling along a straight line, it'll be roughly a straight line on the actual land as well. And so different projections will do that to differing success. And the Mercator projection, which is probably the most famous projection as of right now, is one that does do direction very well, and that's why it's used very commonly and been used, because it was very useful for navigation. We also have bearing, which I don't know exactly what that means. Distance, so how far things are from each other. Usually with equal distance, you can't actually do it from, everything can't be right. That's just not possible in changing a globe into a flat surface. But you can have it so that everything is a correct distance from a certain point. And so we'll see a map that is equal distance from one of the poles. So, see that. And then equal scale. So, just kind of making everything. So most of the best, so there's not really any map that is the be all end all, because there's always going to be a sacrifice in one of those areas for preference in another. So the most popular maps right now, for a world map, are usually a composite, so not really a true, you don't really have any aspect that's 100% correct, but kind of using a bit of weighing up to decide what the cartographers think is the best mix of those sort of things. But before we get into that, let's just go and we'll look at our little Mercator. So if you look here, this is the Mercator projection of the world map. So some things to notice here is, and this is probably up until the 90s, this was a very common, and so Mercator was created in the 1500s as a projection. Obviously, the world was not mapped as well, so the original map, I actually looked it up for this video, but it looked really bizarre, so I probably won't show that because it doesn't really resemble, it's not very good for comparing what we're looking at. So, things to notice here. You have Greenland. If you look at Greenland, which is hopefully you know a little bit about geography, but Greenland is our big white island right there up in the top middle. And then we have Africa. And Greenland looks bigger than Africa. And that is a little bit of a problem because Africa is actually 14 times larger than Greenland. So, part of the issue that you get with the Mercator map is, I'll show you here. So, this is a little bit of an example. So, what you can see is it's a cylindrical projection. So that means is it takes the globe and it kind of opens it up. So it kind of takes these top bits, opens it up, but fills that in. So it stretches those bits out. So these bits that are all actually really close together get put up and then stretched out so that you can then have a flat map. So and so at the equator, things are roughly, that's where you have the most accuracy, is around the equator. But towards your poles, you have really big distortions. So Russia, so we'll put the Mercator back up. So you can see Russia looks much bigger than Africa, whereas Africa is much larger. And so that was something that I actually learned when I was learning about map projections. I'd never realized how big Africa was, and that's because these sort of projections make it look like Russia is really the really big country. So, obviously, Africa's not a country, but I just mean comparatively, those land masses that Eurasia off this way looks a lot bigger. Other issue you have is down south, Antarctica looks like the biggest continent when it's actually the fifth largest continent. So it's much, much smaller. So just really interesting. It does have these lines of constant course. So you can, like, so if you're out on the ocean going from Europe to the Americas or that sort of thing, they could chart where they were going along parallel lines and follow that. Only issue is it's the geographic, so it works for a map, but your compass direction is actually slightly different because your magnetic north is different than the actual geographic north pole. So, a little bit of an issue there, but the Mercator is also a version of the Mercator. It's called the Webb Mercator. It is used for Google Maps, Bing Maps, that sort of thing. So if you really zoom out, you'll see a projection that looks kind of similar to the Mercator. But that's because on a zoomed in level, it is very accurate for distances and for that line of constant course. So just for really giving you a good idea of that. But obviously it's not that good for giving you an overall picture of the varying sizes and that sort of thing. So I'm going to save my favorite projection for the last. And that projection, I haven't been able to find a commercially produced map in that one. And that is the answer as to why I don't have a world map. It's because I want the specific projection that I want. But anyway, so we'll look here. It's another projection. So this is the good homolocene projection. It's a pseudo-cylindrical equal area, and it's called an orange peel map. So if you think about having a ball, or in this case, because they call it an orange peel, by smooshing that out, if you don't extend these top areas, then you're gonna get these little broken out areas. So you can think about it when you peel an orange and if you were trying to lay that flat. So that's what gives you these little kind of little chunking up cuts. It's not just purely like that though, but so that's one projection. It's quite useful because it's equal area, so it tells you the correct sizes. So if you're looking at, you can see Africa to Greenland is much better, although I think Greenland's split. But you can see Africa and to Russia. There's a lot better correspondence there. And you can also see the United States compared to Australia. Those are roughly the same in area. So it's kind of useful. I don't like it because it doesn't feel like a globe. It feels all chopped up to me. And so it's hard for me to conceptualize that as what the world is like. I do like the equal area aspect, but it feels very, it's kind of chopped up and like if you're wanting to go to really understand a part that's around a particular part, it feels not that good for that. We also have, next we'll look at the Albers projection. So this is a conic map. It's an equal area map. But obviously shape and scale are not preserved. So you can see there's actually, lots of different equal area maps. Some look really, really funky. But this map, it's basically treats the Earth like a cone. So it's doing it like it's a cone like that, and then unpeeling that and bringing it around. And so that's how we get that shape. And once again, for me, I don't really think of the Earth in a cone shape. It's useful for the equal area aspect to figure out what the corresponding sizes are, but doesn't have a lot of other benefit, as far as I think. We azimuthal equidistant. Let's show that one here. This is kind of a cool map. So this is taken from the perspective of the North Pole, although for this sort of projection, you could really choose any point that you wanted to. And so everything is equal distance from that pole. So obviously everything around that outside circle, probably draw it this way, is Antarctica, because it's the opposite pole. But so everything that you can see, you can measure, and everything, how far away it is from the pole, is completely maintained. So it's kind of an interesting map. It is also used, if you see here, that's actually the projection that's used on the United Nations symbol. So you can see it's an azimuthal equidistant map with some little bits around the outside. So, you see lots of different map projections and lots of different uses. And I think the reason for the United Nations to choose the azimuthal with the North Pole is I think it's a kind of sitting on the top of the world. Nobody owns the North Pole, that sort of thing. It's a very kind of symbolic of being, oh, like you can sit on top of here and see the whole world and everything's the same distance, and it's not really focusing on one particular area. Obviously it's going to favor the northern hemisphere more than the southern hemisphere. It's kind of the nature of it because it is pointed there, but there's not really any political, because you see a lot of maps that do favor one or another. Well, I mean, for example, a lot of the projections that we've seen so far, they all have the Atlantic Ocean in the middle, and I think all of the ones I do actually have the Atlantic Ocean in the middle, which is a very Eurocentric view, kind of a Euro and American-centric view. You can get projections that are, oh, theoretically, I mean, it's a globe, so you can roll it all around, you could have your projections be from anywhere, really. So it's always something interesting to think about. So when we get to our next one, because that one you can't really turn it inside, but I'll show you. Let's see, we'll do the Robinson next. Let's look at this one. So this is a composite projection. It's got more distortion at the poles, but its goal is basically to minimize distortion, but it's, and so it's not a true equal area or equal distant or equal direction. It's not really true anything, but it's kind of a composite. The whole idea of it is to be a map that you would put up on your wall to kind of understand a bit better the world that you live in. But for example, so I've put it this way, which is our normal way, but because this is basically a bowl, we could also flip it on its head. And that's not incorrect. It's not really anything. It's unconventional. But there's nothing about looking at the globe and putting that into a map that means it has to be one way or another. So my dad actually gave me a gift one time of a, well, on my first marriage, so that's why I don't have it anymore, but it was a What's Up South, and it was a map that had the southern at the top and kind of flipped around like this. And then it also centered on the Pacific Ocean rather than the Atlantic Ocean. So it just gives you a bit of a different perspective. Just something to remember. So the Robinson was the preferred projection of the National Geographic Society up until, I think, the 80s or 90s. And then that's when they changed to, this is the current one, the Winkle Trippel. This was created by Winkle in 1928, and it's called the trapel because it aims to decrease distortion of three key aspects: area, direction, and distance. And so, again, it's not a true equal area, it's not a true equidistant, it's not a true correct direction map, but it's a composite that aims to approach that. And so it's quite a good map. If you see probably a lot of world maps that come out nowadays are Winkle Trapel. So it's good for that, but there is a little bit of distortion. It has a little bit less distortion at the poles than the Robinson did, so that's really why it became the preferred map. So that's our Winkle Trapel. And now I will unveil my preferred map. So here we have a Mullwide projection. So to me, what I love about a Mullwide projection, it is a true equal area map. So every landmass, every bit of ocean, everything that you see on there is in correct scale to each other. So Australia to the US, Africa to Greenland, Africa to Russia, they are all in the correct area, like all of the areas are completely correct. And I like the purity of that because I feel like my understanding of the world has been shaped by that. You can see by the shapes there is a bit of distortion with the shapes. And for me, that's something because the shapes at the center tend to be, you can kind of see that they're not distorted as much, and it distorts a little bit more as you go off to the sides. For me, I can kind of visualize that as a curve, and I can see what the normal shape would actually be like if you kind of rotated it around mentally for me. So the distortion on the shapes doesn't bother me that much because it's distorted in a very predictable way. I also like that it's in an ellipse shape, so you get that feel of the Earth and its roundness and that it's a globe. Obviously, any sort of flat map is never going to be completely spherical, but I find it very satisfying. I also like that you can see the whole Earth all together, so as opposed to the good Homolocene, we have something, it's all continuous. So you don't have little, it's not that orange peel effect where you have little chopped up bits coming out. So that is the Mullwide projection. I am actually debating getting a Winkle Trapel map because you can actually buy one. I've been looking for probably 3 years to try and get a Mullwide projection, and I'd probably have to either get it commissioned or find somebody who does one and just print it out. But I like to have like a nice laminated, nice put together map, so it's kind of a bit of a toss up between those. So that is my debate about projections. So let me know what your favorite projection was that I shared, or if you have another map projection that you prefer, let me know. If you have any questions, put them down in the comments down below. I could definitely do another video on map projections. There are so many map projections, but I thought I would just share a few. There's all sorts of shapes and sizes that are used to turn this globe into a flat. So, that is all I have today. Remember, if you do comment, you can get featured in my for a chance to get featured in my viewers appreciation, which is the 25th of each month. Have a wonderful time, and just remember that a globe can be projected into all sorts of different shapes. So when you see a map, don't just take it at face value. Understand that there's distortion in every map.